Hello my dear friends, this is a Painty Cat and today we're going to paint a really cute basket with Easter eggs and willow twigs. We're starting with very easy sketch. It's a basket and a small flowers around. Now, I'm planning 3 eggs in this basket. Just main shapes. And shape of twigs also. You can find all sketches of my tutorials. Follow link below. You can print sketch and transfer to the watercolor paper easily. I'm using kneaded rubber, removing some pencil from paper, and today I'm going to use acrylic in 2 different ways. First, I'm going to paint as we usually do with watercolor. I'm not using any white basic layer. I'm just making cobalt blue very watery and creating color basic layer. You can see acrylic looking absolutely similar to watercolor, isn't it? Now we have to dry this basic layer. This is a very important. I'm using hair dryer. That's it. I'm touching paper and I can feel it's completely dry at the moment. Now I'm taking a very small brush, it's number 0, and I'm going to create crochet tablecloth. You can choose any pattern you like, you prefer. I'm just creating pattern similar to tablecloth I really have. It was crocheted by my grandmother. As you can see, I created a basic shape, half round, and repeating small element many times. At the moment I'm planning future shapes for main pattern. It's a net. Now I'm going to put more details. So I'm just repeating the shape of each square. It's just square in square. I'm using just clear white. There is no water. White color, not watery at all. I really like acrylic dyes because we can use it, look two ways, two different ways. It's similar to watercolor as a basic layer, and after we can create next layers that completely covering color under it. Now I put small elements. You can create some small flowers in it, and as you can see, now my crochet tablecloth done. Now it's time to paint small basket. I'm using just clear umber. You can see I have no any blue as a basic there, so it's just clean paper. So we have to create a basic layer first. It's mix of umber, of brown and white. I'd say it's a middle color. And fill the whole shape. You don't have to create a really smooth color. It can be visible strokes in it. And as soon as shape filled with color, we have to wait till this area will be dry. And this time, while we're waiting, let's create Easter eggs. Choose any colors you like. As for me, I like yellow color. I'm mixing yellow with a white for better coverage. Next color, I want to mix red and yellow. I'd say it's a very, very bright orange, but more red than yellow. Still, it's a mix. This way, this kind of red, this warm red, will looking better with a yellow egg. And the last one will be blue. It's just cobalt blue, mixed with a small amount of white, again for better coverage. We have to wait now till our Easter eggs will be dry completely, and after create any pattern you prefer. I like some stripes, some triangles. Color of pattern, I prefer just white. But of course, you can add also any colors you like. This greeting card is really, really easy. So try. You can share to me result your own greeting card in my community in Facebook. Just follow the link below. And this is the last egg. It's dark blue, so pattern here really looking very contrasted. That's it, and it's time to create basket. Look, I'm just making short horizontal strokes and some vertical lines as well. That's it, our basket done. I'm cleaning my hands and my brushes with wet wipes. It's just faster and really handy. And I want to create some small violet flowers here. First, I'm using dark shade. Also, some flowers could fall down from our basket and it's laying on our crochet tablecloth. That's it, our flowers, at least first layer of it done. Now I will mix green and white. A little bit of yellow, and we have to create small leaves. I will put some yellow light details in the middle of each flower. And now it's time to create willow twigs. I'm using very small brush number one. Let's put small dots like this. I'm cleaning my brush at the moment because I have to use clear white. And now we're painting round shaped strokes around each dark brown dot. This kind of twigs you can see in early spring, very beautiful and very popular here where I'm living to celebrate Easter. Mix a little bit yellow and white and put this kind of shade in the middle of each white detail on twig. Just a little bit. And I want also add some ribbon on top of twigs. I'm mixing same violet shade as I used for flowers. cleaning my brush at the moment, mixing violet and white for a really light shade, because I want to create some light on flower petals. Not everywhere, not many, just to create more realistic look for little flowers. Same details as I created for small flowers, I did for green leaves, just in another shade. This time I took the darker shade. That's it, my dear friends. It was a Painty Cat, and I wish you happy Easter. Subscribe to my channel. We will have more interesting tutorials. Bye bye.